Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Monday, December 3rd, 2007. In the pre-market this morning, we've got futures basically hovering around unchanged this morning. A little bit of an uptick in the NASDAQ, but not a lot. Futures have been just moving around between unchanged most of the morning, so really not a lot of direction here. Crude oil's down almost a buck, and gold has dropped below the 780 area. So we're going to be looking for a little bit of weakness in commodities this morning. Equities basically unchanged going into the open at 9:30. Okay, taking a look at some 60-minute charts this week. Last week at this time, we were looking for the TSX to come up and fill that open gap, and that's exactly where it got to. The next target on the upside is up here, so we don't have that far to go to hit our first target to the our next target to the upside. Looking over our shoulder, looking lower, we're looking for an hourly close below 13,580 on the TSX to tell us that this intraday uptrend is probably over. Okay, looking at the S&P 500, last week we were looking to move up to this cluster area, and that's exactly what we did. Next target on the upside is 1,500, about 20 points, and 20 points on the S&P is about 140 points on the Dow. Looking over our shoulder again, we're going to be monitoring for an hourly close below 1460 on the S&P 500. That would tell us that this intraday uptrend is probably over. Okay, looking at the NASDAQ, we were looking to come up to this cluster area, and that's where we got to. And the next move to the upside for the NASDAQ is up to the 2800 level. So we've got a lot of room to go on the upside, and looks like there's a takeover in the technology sector this morning that could help propel us up into that direction. Okay, looking downward, looking at the NASDAQ, we're looking for an hourly close below 2630 on Monday to kick us out and tell us that the intraday uptrend is probably over. Moving forward, Activision is being taken out today, and it got a buy signal last week and has moved higher, and now it's being taken out. It's up by, 20-25% in European trading. So Activision, if you look at the weekly chart of Activision, it's a stock that I don't personally own, and I don't, it's been a long time since I've traded it at all, but it would have met my criteria if I was looking at Activision. Long-term uptrend on the flypaper channel is up. Stock's been able to come down and find support and turn around from that support. It did that last week as well, came down, started to move higher. So that's something I'm looking for in a stock. And we'll be taking a look at flypaper channels in a minute, but you know, using the flypaper channel and looking to see how thick or thin, this is a fairly thin channel, which means there's lots of opportunity for capital gains. That's a stock that would certainly meet my criteria. Now, looking at some other technology stocks we've been following, Apple Computer. We need to see a daily close below 170 to kick us out of Apple Computer, a daily close below 652 on Google to kick us out this week, and a daily close below 111 on the RIM in the U.S. And RIM had a bad day on Friday, but not enough to give it a sell signal. If there's follow-through on Monday, we're going to need to see a daily close below 111 to kick us out of RIM. Now, Dell got whacked on Friday, and Dell's not a stock that comes up on my radar very often, and I'll show you why. If you look at Apple Computer's daily flypaper channel and look at how thin it is, that the actual thickness of the channel tells us that it's a very volatile stock, that it's so thin. Now, the other thing that I look for is look at the direction of this stock. It is still motoring higher, even though the stock market has had weakness recently. The long-term view of Apple is that it's still moving higher, and it's been able to come down to the flypaper channel, have support, and start to turn around. That's a good thing. Now, similar situation for Google. Google's flypaper channel is not as thin, but it's fairly thin compared to other stocks, and we'll show you one in a minute just as a comparison. But it has been able to come down to the flypaper channel, find support, and start to turn around. I like that. And that's also true of RIM. RIM has been able to come down to the flypaper channel, find support, and turn around. Those are all good qualities. Those are qualities I look for in a stock. Now compare that to this. Here's the daily flypaper channel for Dell. Now there's a lot of things wrong with this. One is the direction. Notice that we've been basically trading sideways for months. Second thing is look at the thickness. It's a fairly wide channel, which means there's not a lot of opportunity for capital gains here. Now, the thickness of the channel means it's a more stable stock. There's also less chance of capital risk But if you're trading the stock and watching the sell signals, you know, that isn't the biggest concern in the world that we have. But on the upside, you know, if you take the move from where the stock was here to up to here, what have you got? About a 15% gain. Now, you wouldn't have got it from point to point, but, you know, that's when you've got a thick flypaper channel, you're not looking for a lot of opportunity for capital gain there. So, and the other thing is that, you know, in the last down move, it broke down through the bottom of the flypaper channel. So it's, you know, telling us that it's very negative, whereas those previous stocks all held their ground above the flypaper channel. And that's telling us that the market wants those stocks compared to Dell, where the Dell chart's telling us that the market doesn't want this stock. So there's no, you know, a chart pattern or what a chart looks like is not going to eliminate catastrophic losses like people had on Friday with this when they got whacked. Now, the only way to really protect yourself from a big loss like this, RIM was down 6% on Friday. Dell was down nearly 13% on Friday. The only way to protect yourself is to have a diversified portfolio. A chart pattern and how the stock looks on a chart will not protect you. You really need a diversified portfolio to protect you from losses like that. Okay, let's look at some uranium stocks. Last week we were looking at Denison Mine. The upper band on the right side channel has continued to move lower, so we need a daily close above 990 on Monday to kick us out. Similar situation for Paladin. We need a daily close above 615 on Monday to kick us out. And it looks like the market wants Uranium 1 because it issued a buy signal on Friday at the close, so we should be buying that stock. If you're looking for uranium stock, then Uranium 1 is probably the one to go with for the moment. Okay, looking at some other stocks. Tech Cominco is a stock I get asked about a lot, and it's on the cusp of giving a new buy signal if it closes higher on Monday. And here's a couple of stocks that people outside of Canada probably don't watch, but in Canada, they're watched by a lot of people. Loblaw is a national grocery chain. It has been going in this direction forever, and it looks like it's found some footing. And we got an early warning signal on Friday. But look at what the pros are doing. They came right down to the bottom, started to turn around. That's probably a sign that we might have found a bottom here. Now, do we have the catalyst to move higher? If we can move higher, then it wouldn't be unreasonable for us to come up to this area right here, just above $40, and get stopped out up at that point. Now, similar situation for Loblaw's parent company, Weston. It got a new early warning signal on Friday. Not a buy signal, just an early warning signal. And again, look at what the pros are doing. So for this particular stock, a move up from 55 to 65 would not be unreasonable for that stock. Okay, that's all for Monday. We're looking for a flat open on Monday morning and some weakness in the commodities. So have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.